Bit of guitar in it.
Extra grip, man.
This is my final 20,000. Laid on a wave so strong. Put the broke down line.
Here we have Harry learning how to join a road. Have you done this?
Jesus.
So earlier this year, me and Tom travelled to Plymouth to view an abandoned sailing yacht.
The motorboat was aground, so we've had to actually kayak out to the boat. But yeah, Tom was doing a good job, so we should be there in no time.
How's that hole looking, Tom?
It turned out to be a dud, but it was too late. We were hooked on finding something better. Not even a week later, we had found something. The only problem was we only had a week to get it ready.
Harry here. It's Thursday 6th, day before launch. Cast off is 24 hours away, so I'm heading down to Thornham to meet Tom and Will. It's the last day of fixing before we put it in the water, so we don't start sinking. I'm only missing a few things now, so a dinghy or a tender, so when we deliver the boat tomorrow, we'll have a way of getting off the boat as well, so we're not stuck in it. And then, we should be ready to go. Sails up, cast off tomorrow. So exciting.
You wear gloves using the seat flex.
What's that?
You wear gloves using the seat flex.
We set about doing all the jobs that needed doing before Shelley went back into the water. This sadly seemed to involve awkward spaces, banging our heads, and a lot of swearing.
So we have just removed this, which is the bolt which holds in our anode. Previous owners had put new anodes on, however the bolts were still rusted, and the point of an anode is it's self-sacrificial, so it takes all the corrosion away from the metal components on our bolt via electric current, so this degrades over time, but it has to be held in by these bolts, and because these are already rusted, the current isn't able to pass through the bolts into the anode, so we've had to replace these bolts. So this is our new bolt, nice and shiny. This plate here sits against your hull, and then this washer and bolt clamps down on it on the other side, and then your electric wires go onto there.
Definitely should have worn disposable gloves for this.
Yeah.
Do you think it's waterproof?
It's pretty quite a important question.
We'll find out.
What are you doing, Tom?
I am trying to attach a Jubilee clip which will hold
the cockpit drain pipe to the pipe which connects onto the seacock, and that's what will take the water out of the cockpit and back into the sea. And it was currently leaking.
Our in-house engineer has gone in for a look.
He's broken the bolt.
If in doubt, get the history of art student to fix it.
Well, see how I wish, because the other day, this like, guy shot me, and it,
yeah. Right, coming in.
Dangerous position.
Where are we at?
Where's the seat? I can't.
That.
Oh, that one.
What's going on here? It looks so wrong.
Are
you doing the
pipe here? No, like that. Does that feel like a tight enough
bit?
Yeah.
No, that's...
No, I'm not talking about the Jubilee bit. I'm saying, is it far enough onto the sea bit? Sing me a lullaby. Days gone by.
Just to get paid, I'm taking one last breath as reality fades. Wasting time on the streets where heroes are made. Now I'm hanging round your place trying to get laid. I got different methods for wasting my day.
He said we should fill up the
pinnacle
and outlet
of Shelley.
The throat.
It's a gleaming example of what Shelley will become. So we were looking at the tap and we found this clear pipe that effectively.
What it was, you shut yourself in the cabin, didn't you? And then you're like, look what I found, and you just come up holding a tap. And we're like, well, if there's a tap, it must be a water tank.
Yeah, that was mad. So we followed it round, and we found it, like, went into that locker.
And then just disappeared. Like, we couldn't see where it went to. So then we were following that pipe, which is, like, the water inlet.
Yeah.
And that went into that locker, and then also disappeared. So we, like, pulled the floor out. And there was just a water bladder underneath it.
And they never fucking told us. Because he didn't ever find it.
So we have a water tank.
Sick.
Yeah.
That is weak
so
to the sea.
So this is the tap that I found. We tested it
with some beer. But there's a little clear hose at the back here. And we followed it around, it goes all the way under there and then back into the cockpit. And it's just connected to the bladder underneath.
It's set to go with a new tap.
It just needs a tap on it.
Sick.
On the source.
And that's the anode and that done.
The anode still needs rewiring.
Oh, but tomorrow, right?
Yeah, exactly. Well, we can do that in the water.
Yeah. We'll probably want to see if we have to tighten it first, then.
Yeah.
So.
24 hours later.
So, we've got Shelley about to go in the water, which isn't quite what we were hoping for right now, because we've realised that the compound sealing the joint between the keel bolts, the anode bolts and the keel, isn't suitable for the job. However, we've come here this morning and Shelley is already on the cradle about to go into the water. So yeah, tensions are a little high, but it'll be okay.
At the end of a busy day, Harry nervously shows us the many creeks we will have to navigate on our way out to the marina, which rather worryingly don't seem to be particularly well marked.
That you can't see.
Why does it wheel so much as well?
So what, you get
somehow gonna navigate this. So yeah, all on tomorrow morning.
How are you feeling? Feeling confident?
Bricking it.
But we know that if we can get out without running aground, Kelly will get to her new mooring safely.
The boat seemed good enough to go, and on the way to the pub, I got a tip-off about a cheap tender and engine, which we swiftly picked up and tested out. And I go where the ocean is deep. There are giants out there in the canyons, and a good captain can fall asleep. They say these waters are in what they used to be. But I got people back online who count on me. So if you see my downeaster Alexa. Thanks to a rushed, intense launch, we weren't able to get much footage. However, we seemed to be doing well and made it to the east head at the mouth of Chichester Harbour for a small break where we anchored up before we sailed round the corner to our mooring at Langston Harbour.
The weather was perfect and things seemed to be going a little bit too well.
So, Shelley update. A little bit wonky. Really pretty sunset. But unfortunately, we're stuck on the bottom bit. Little pro sailor tip. Stay in the wet bit.
We made the difficult decision to abandon ship to the nearest pub until the tide returned.
We returned to Shelley, and with Harry on helm, keeping a close eye on depth, and me acting as a tugboat in the tender, Shelley made it just a bit later than expected to her new home.
5 minutes, we should be home. Shelley's back on her mooring. She's looking good. We've just taken her off of where she was ground for about
just
an hour, did you say?
Just
a few hours, yeah. But it was a swift operation, wasn't it?
It was, we did well.
It was Harry on helm, Tom on bow, yep. And I was sort of tugboat. And we made it work.
Yeah, we ran aground at about 5:30, 8:30.
What's time now?
8:30.
Yeah, I was here.
Happy days.
Yeah.
On the mooring, safe and sound.
Just getting dark.
Maiden voyage done.
Tick, but completed.
We've completed it.
We've done all the bits we never need to do again now, so.
Like run aground.
We've mapped out the harbour.
Easy. Alright, signing off.
Signing off, boys.
A few days later, following a big storm that had blown through the south coast, me and Tom went back to check on Shelley
and what we found was heartwarming. Shelley was sat high and dry on the mooring, no leaks or breaks, and perfectly sat at the end of the rainbow.
Qui me souriait. Puis il a plu sous cette plage, dans cet orage, elle a disparu. Et j'ai crié, crié à lui pour qu'elle revienne, et j'ai pleuré.